So there's an onus on him to get a grip and put United under pressure, because that's what they did in the first 15-20 minutes and actually got some joy.
Here's a chance for Dodds, he's clear now with a great chance for Dundee! 29 minutes gone, Dundee go ahead and the scorer is Billy Dodds.
Well, it's no surprise it's that young man with 17 goals to his credit already, Jock, that he's the one that's opened the scoring. It comes at a time when Dundee... And I'm sure another long throw on its way to the box.
Ferguson helping out on there, the equaliser, surely it's McKinnon! A superb reply by Dundee United. Oh, what a fine reply!
Well, they'd always threatened, Jock, for the last 10 minutes, it's been a good reply. And once again, it's a Bowman long throw, the Ferguson flick on, and there's Ray McKinnon doing what all good midfield players should do, getting in where it hurts, and finishing very, very confidently indeed. Just the boost that United wanted before half-time.
Well, what an incredible reply by Dundee United. Raymond McKinnon getting only his second goal of the season. Could scarcely have been more welcome.
Couldn't stop himself going into him, but he looks a very tough, uncompromising young character.
Well, Ray McKinnon had his troubles at Tannadice earlier in the season, clashing with the manager Jim McLean, and has returned recently to the fold. Jackson with enough pace, he's away from Craig. Here to be eased off that, there's Jackson again, this must be the leading goal! Brilliant play by Jackson! Pace initially, and then skill and determination, giving United the lead.
Well, it looks as if he was saying to Billy Dodds, anything you can do, I can do better. And it's his blistering pace that gives him the opportunity. Matt Cave just can't cope with it, but he shows great strength here. He may have gone down there, Jock, but he shows determination. Going to get up. It's not finished for him yet. Great finish. But not unexpected at all.
Well, a goal which has been threatened right from the start of the second half. Jackson appeared to be eased out of that, but look at the way he kept his eye on the ball, made that opportunity for himself, then showed that delightful touch to get away from Tom Carson and beat Brad Shannon to the loose ball.
Looking at that again, Jock, I bet you Mark Cave thinking to himself, why didn't I just clear it? Because he did get to the ball first, he could have cleared it out for a corner or a throw-in.
Campbell, back to McMartin, Jackson's layoff, here's Ferguson. Help over on the far side in the form of John O'Neill. Looking to run at Dinny once again. Such a tricky player, that's good running by O'Neill. There's the header by Ferguson! And that should tie it up for Dundee United. Well, a goal which Dundee United cannot begrudge.
Certainly not, and no surprise again, Jock. Now a very tired looking Dundee side. You see he's involved right away, Ferguson. He plays it to O'Neill and starts to make his way like all tall strikers to the far post. John O'Neill thinks, I'll deliver it there. The rest's up to you. And that's a good header. Tom Carson giving no chance. But what's good about this cross, Jock, is when you get to a certain angle, you can't look near post because defenders go and block it. Look at Mark Crave, he's in there blocking the near post. So it's good awareness on O'Neill's part to look to the back post, where goalkeepers have got a long way to go to get across the goal and block it.
Well, 19-year-old Duncan Ferguson's third goal of the season, and he has made a very big impression in a short time in the Dundee United first team.